This video is sponsored by DA Lubricant Company. Give your fleet bumper-to-bumper protection. Visit dalube.com to learn more.
Hi, David here, and this week we're on the road again, as MagDefense recently invited us out to experience the delivery of the first production M917 A3 Heavy Dump Trucks, or HDTs as I'll refer to them moving forward, to the U.S. Army and the U.S. Army Reserve. They were the first to roll off the company's new production line at the MAC Experience Center in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Now, interestingly, MAC should feel right at home producing vehicles for the Army, because the company's trademark Bulldog nickname was earned in 1917 during World War I. MAC delivered several thousand trucks in Europe at the time, and the British soldiers, when facing daunting terrain, would yell to send in the MAC Bulldogs because of the truck's blunt-nosed hood and reputation for durability. It reminded them of their country's mascot, the British Bulldog. Now, this latest delivery was a big deal for both the Army and for MAC, as these HDTs are actually the first new heavy tactical wheeled vehicles the US Army has added to its portfolio in 12 years. In fact, according to Army officials during the event, the Army's current dump truck fleet includes some variants that are nearly 50 years old, so these trucks are quite a welcome addition to the fleet. Now, these HDTs are based on the commercially available vocational MAC Granite model. The Army says it plans to use these dump trucks in its engineer units, and they will be key in construction and maintenance missions for infrastructure assets, both at home and abroad. We're talking roadways, airfields, landing strips, supply facilities, motor pools, things like that. The 94,500-pound GVWR HDTs feature an all-wheel drive 8x8 configuration, and again, these are based on the MAC Granite model. To meet the Army's payload and mobility requirements, MAC Defense says its engineers had to increase the suspension's ride height. An armored cab was also engineered, utilizing all the comfort features and amenities of a commercial truck, while adding force protection to help keep any occupants safe in hostile environments. Talking power, these HDTs are powered by 13-liter MAC MP8 engines, delivering 440 horsepower and 1,660 pound-feet of torque. The vehicle has a 27-ton payload without armor installed, and a 22.5-ton payload when fully armored. MAC Defense says these HDTs that were purpose-built for the Army are somewhere in the neighborhood of being 75-80% a standard MAC Granite model, but with enhancements made to cater to military unique requirements like off-road capabilities and enhanced survivability. On the HDTs, you'll find engineers added heavy-duty rear axles, all-wheel drive, and increased ride height suspension. The HDT also features active safety systems, such as active blind spot detection, forward-looking collision avoidance, and anti-lock brakes, which MAC Defense President David Hartzell says were requirements by the Army. While the Army is interested in telematics capabilities through a program like MAC's Guard Dog Connect solution, well, Hartzell says the Army isn't quite ready for it. Now, I was able to talk with Hartzell during the event, and I apologize for the background noise you're going to hear. It was raining cats and dogs, and the whole event was outdoors, so it got a little intense.
The Army did not ask for a telematics gateway, like our Guard Dog solution. Mm-hmm. Since we got the contract award, we presented that to them. They actually tested our system at Aberdeen, and because the Army's actually interested in doing that now. Because obviously they realize the benefits of having something that where they can remotely monitor the vehicle, and if there's maintenance required, if there's faults required, you know, that are going to happen, they can help diagnose that, predictive maintenance, all those sort of things. Because the Army's realizing that, especially the Reserve and the National Guard, many times these vehicles are operated domestically. They're not OCONUS, they're CONUS, right? So they say, hey, look, why wouldn't we take advantage of that? And then if we get in a situation where they're state of national emergency or something, and they want to disable that system, they just want to be able to turn it off so that you lose that connectivity. They don't want people tracking their vehicles or cyberly hacking their vehicles and so on, right? So,
sure.
And the Army does have more stringent cybersecurity requirements than what we currently have on our commercial vehicles. So we're going through that with them right now on some of those system capabilities.
Surprisingly to me, duty cycle requirements coming from the Army were an easy target for Mac to meet. And it makes sense when you think about how a truck like the Granite is used in commercial settings versus how the Army likely intends to use the HDTs.
Yeah, they have mean time between failure requirements, then obviously serviceability requirements, you know, service interval requirements and so on. Obviously we meet all of that because in a typical commercial application, our vehicles are used almost 24/7. Mm-hmm. You get a construction, you know, company that's using dump trucks in their commercial operation. They're working a lot of hours. They put a lot, quite honestly, even for a construction vehicle, they put quite a few miles on it. Mm-hmm. You'll see in military vehicles, in 20 years, you'll go and look at that vehicle, it'll have 1,500 miles on it.
Yeah.
Because they sit in motor pool most of the time, and they're only brought out when they need to be brought out. So the actual operational duty cycles are quite honestly significantly different than what our typical commercial work cycles are, life cycles are, operational cycles are. So quite honestly, it's fairly easy for our products to meet those requirements.
Production of the HDTs at the Mack Experience Center began in the first quarter of 2021, following an investment of $6.5 million to create a dedicated HDT production line in the facility. The new production line helps fulfill the HDT contract with the U.S. Army, and Mack Defense expects the production line to produce around a truck a day for the foreseeable future. Mack Defense also partnered with 2.5 dozen suppliers to help put this vehicle together. The company went to Chris Steele to couple the HDT's dump body with Chris Steele's material control system tailgate. Michelin supplies the tires, which are Michelin XZY3 wide-base tires. Meritor Defense was tapped for the front and rear axles, brake systems, transfer case, and drive shafts. Hendrickson supplies the rear suspension system, and JWF Defense fabricates the armored cab, plus over 30 other parts, sub-assemblies, and chemical agent-resistant coating painting expertise used on each model. So that's everything on Mack Defense's new M917A3 heavy dump trucks. It was very cool to see these beasts up close and in person. I'm David Sickles, this is On the Road, and as always, for more trucking equipment content, head over to fleetequipmentmag.com. We'll see you next time.